Hello guys, welcome to you. In this video, we are going to see how to fix Wi-Fi is not showing in a settings on Windows 10 PC or laptop. We are going to fix missing Wi-Fi issue in Windows 10 PC or laptop. First, we see our problem, then solve this problem. I go to the here we find network connection, and here we find network and internet settings and not any Wi-Fi connection or the any Wi-Fi. And also in a start, I go to the settings. Click on the settings, go to the network and internet, and here we find there is no network adapter or the Wi-Fi adapter on our Windows 10 PC or laptop. This is our problem, and I give the multiple solution to fix this problem, and I hope one of these method is work for you. So let's go to our video. First we go to the here and check our problem is the our hardware or the network card or our Windows 10 OS is problem. First, go to the start, type cmd, right click on the command prompt, click on the run as an administrator. Run as an administrator is very imp. Click on the yes. Here we find our command prompt. Here type ping space 127.1.1.1. Type ping space 127.1.1.1 and hit enter key on our keyboard, and it's reply with our pin. That means there is no problem with our hardware or the network card. Our problem is with our Windows 10 operating system only. And we are going to fix this. Close it. Our second step is reset internet option. That is very easy. Go to the start. Type control panel. Click on the control panel. In control panel, find internet option. Find internet option. Here you find internet option. Click on the internet options. In internet option, here is the internet options. I minimize it. Here we find advanced tab. Go to the advanced tab. In advanced tab, we here we find restore advanced settings. Click on the restore advanced settings. After that, click on the reset. Click on the reset. Click on the reset and close it. Apply it and go to the start. Go to the power button. Restart your machine and restart your machine. After restart, I hope your problem must be solved. If not, then I give the second method or the third method also. Our third method is also very simple. Our third method is services. Go to the start, type services, click on the services. In services, find wlan auto config. If it's running, it is running. That means there is no problem with this setup. If it's not with the running or any other issue, then go to the here, right click on it. Click on the properties, and if it's in startup type, if it's in automatic, if it's automatic delay, manual or disabled, then change it to automatic. Make sure it is set to automatic and make sure it is start. Click on the start. If it's stopped, then go to the start. If it's stopped, paused or the resume, go to the start, start it, apply it, click on OK. And here we find it is running. It is IMP. It is running. It's very IMP. Close it. And go to the start, power button, restart, and restart our machine. Restart our machine is very IMP. After machine is restart, we go to the our second method. After machine is restart, check our Wi-Fi connection is showing on our PC or not. If it's not showing, then I give the third solution, a fourth solution. Fourth solution is also very simple. I go to the start, type settings, click on the settings. In settings, go to the network and internet. Click on the network and internet. In network and internet, scroll down, and here we find change adapter options. Click on the change adapter options. Here we find our all adapters. In my case, I go to the Wi-Fi. If it's enabled, then go to the disable it. Disable it. If it's enabled, then disable it. And after that, go to there, right click on it. Click on enable once again. After enable, go to there and disable once again. Enable it. After that, go to the here you find network and connections, go to the here, and this time it's showing me my Wi-Fi connections on my PC. If it's not showing, then go to the our next method. I close some all windows from here. Our fifth method is device manager. It is a very easy and simple. Go to the start, right click on it. Here you find device manager, click on the device manager. In device manager, we find many things. Go to the network adapter. Here we find network adapter. Go to the network adapter, find the your network adapter or the Wi-Fi device. In this case, this is the my Wi-Fi device. find your Wi-Fi device. There is not many options, one or two options. Find your Wi-Fi, right click on your Wi-Fi device, and here we find update driver. Go to the update driver. Here we find two options. Automatic is not available for us. Our network is or internet is not working condition. So we code the browse my computer for drivers. Here we find let me pick up a list from available drivers on my computer. Here we find models. If any outdated or the backdated drivers are available with your machine, if 2-3 drivers are available, then go to the backdated drivers. In my case, there is the one driver, so I click on this driver and click on the next. It's installing our drivers. It takes few minutes, so be a patient and wait for a few minutes or few seconds. Close it. If it's not working after restart your machine, and if it's not working, then go to the our second method. Second method is right click on the our Wi-Fi and click on the properties this time. And here go to the power management, click on the power management. In power management, uncheck this, allow the computer to turn off this device to save power. Save power, it's automatically off your Wi-Fi connection. That's why uncheck it, click on OK and restart your machine, and your problem might may be solved. If it's not working, then I go to the another method. Another method is uninstall. Uninstall our drivers and restart our machine. After restarting our machine, our drivers are automatically installed on our PC or laptop, and our problem is solved. This is our method. Go to here, right click on it. Here we find uninstall device. Click on uninstall device. Click on uninstall. It's uninstalling our device. It takes few minutes, and here is no device on our network adapter. Close it. Go to the start. Go to the power button and restart our machine. After machine is restart, check our drivers are installed or not. Go to the start, right click on it. Go to the device manager. In device manager, here you find our drivers are automatically installed by our Windows 10 PC or laptop. Check our Wi-Fi is working or not. If it's working, then okay. If it's not working, then go to the our next method. Next method is network reset. Go to the start, type settings, click on the settings. In settings, find network and internet. Click on the network and internet. In network and internet, scroll down, and here we find network reset option. Click on network reset, and it's reset or delete your all related network. Everything is start as a fresh. Click on this reset now. It's reset your all network, ethernet and the other adapters. Click on the yes, and it's ask you to the restart. It's restart in a 5 minutes. Close it. You can manually restart also. Go to the start. Go to the power button and restart your machine. After restart, it's asked to start your network. Click on yes and check if your Wi-Fi is working or not. If it's not working, then go to the our next method. Next method is reset IPv4 on your PC or laptop. Go to the start, type cmd, right click on the command prompt, run as administrator. Click on run as administrator. It is imp run as administrator. Here is the our command prompt. And here I add some command. I queue this all command in the YouTube description. Here we find first command NETSH space win WINSOSCK space RESET and hit enter key on your keyboard. First command is successfully executed. Our second command is also very simple. NETSH space INT space IP space reset RESET space reset log.txt and hit enter key on your keyboard. All is okay. That means our all things are reset now. Close it and go to the start and restart our machine. Restart our machine. Restart our machine. It solves your problem. If not, then I go to the our next method. If this all methods is not work for you, the next method is go to the any other PC that has a working internet and download the our Wi-Fi drivers. Here go to the any web browser and type your motherboard name, your laptop name, or built-in PC that type your Wi-Fi name. If you're using TP-Link, then TP-Link, Intel, or any other, then type the your Wi-Fi name and download the drivers. In this case, I am using, or for this example, I am using SS network adapter. So I go to the SS. You can go to the your network adapter. In this example, for example, I go to the SS and I type the SS network adapter driver. Hit enter key. Go to the first link. Here type the your model number. In this case, I type Zenbook UX and click on the first link. Go to the driver and utility and select the your operating system, Windows 11 or Windows 10 or any other. Select the, your operating system. In this case, I select the Windows 10. Here we find our Wi-Fi driver at here. Click on the download and download the driver and copy and paste that driver on your PC and install that drivers on your PC. That also resolve your issue on your Windows 10 PC or laptop. Our last method is very simple. Go to the start, type system config. Here type system config. Click on the system config. In system config, go to the services, go to the services. In services, click on enable all, click on enable all. Click on the apply, click on the OK. It's ask you to the restart, click on exit, restart or the restart. I want to restart, click on the restart and restart your machine. After restart, check our Wi-Fi is working or not. That is very easy. Go to the here, click at here. Here we find our Wi-Fi network. Click on any network that you want. Add your password, connect it and add your password. Click on the next. Our Wi-Fi is connected. Check our Wi-Fi is working or not. Go to the, our start, our Google Chrome. And type anything. I'm typing Google. And that's all. Our Wi-Fi is working. It is connected. So guys, this is the multiple ways to fix this problem. And I hope one of these methods is work for you. So guys, thank you for watching this video. Don't forget to like, share, comment on this video and don't forget to subscribe the channel. Thank you guys.